Hello everyone, I am back with a new quiz, a new chapter for grade 5. So today's chapter is fractions, and as you know, there are certain questions. For each question, I'm going to give you 10 seconds approximately, and also you can pause the video and read the question for better understanding, and then you can check your answer, right? So let's get started. Your first question is in front of you. Which is the equivalent fraction for 1/4? All right, let me give you some hint. As I have already told in the previous videos also, always try to eliminate the options in MCQs. Over here, straight away, these two options are eliminated, because equivalent fraction of 1/4, if I have to find, there will be some changes in the numerator, right? Because it is not the same fractions in B and D part, right? So for 1/4, in both these fractions, I have numerator 2, right? So to get the numerator 2, I will multiply by 2. And the number with which I'm multiplying the numerator, I will same. With the same number, I will multiply the denominator also to get the equivalent fraction. So over here, 2/8 is the equivalent fraction. And this is our correct answer. Well done. One more. Which is the equivalent fraction for 1/3? And I'm sure this time you are going to get the answer quickly. Eliminate the options, everyone. Absolutely. A part, this is eliminated because it is 3/3. That's not possible. Then 2/3 is not possible. Then 2/6. Let us check. To get the numerator 2, I will multiply by 2. So 2/6. Absolutely. So 2/6 is our equivalent fraction for 1/3. Find the greatest common factor of 12 and 24. Greatest common factor or HCF, highest common factor of 12 and 24. All right, let me now tell you the method. We'll take up the division method over here. So the greater number becomes your dividend and the smaller number becomes your divisor. So over here, 12 to the 24, 0. So in this method, kids, the last divisor is our HCF. So the answer is 12. Here we have got the remainder at once only. So the last divisor is 12 only. So 12 is our answer. Please don't get confused over here. These are the mixed numbers. All right. So it is, let me write it down for more clarity. It is 3 1/4 minus 2 8/11. Now, of course, these such sums are going to take some time. So you can definitely pause the video and get the answer. Now, the first step over here, is to, yes, convert these mixed fractions into improper fractions. So over here, it will be 13/4 minus 30/11. Now, 4 and 11, you can see 4 and 11 are co-primes. 4 and 11 are co-primes. So 1 is the HCF. So what will be your LCM over here? When you have co-primes, the LCM is their product. So 44 is your LCM. Since 44 is our LCM, so let's now convert them into like fractions. 13/4 becomes your minus 120/44. So after subtraction, you get the answer. 3 minus 0 is 3. 4 minus 2 is 2. 23 upon 44 is your answer. So here it is 23. Just a correction, that 23 upon 44, and this is your correct answer. Since 23 upon 44, it is your proper fraction. So proper fractions, we cannot convert them into mixed numbers. So 23 upon 44 is your final answer. Our next question over here is 5, 1 upon 2 minus 4, 7 upon 8. Start solving, kids. I am just, briefly explaining these steps that are involved in solving such questions. All right, let's move ahead. You can pause the video to take some time, more time to solve the question. But such questions should not take more than 2 minutes. You must have the timer with you. You shouldn't be taking more than 2 minutes in solving such questions. All right, so as I already told, the first step is to convert mixed fractions into improper fractions. So 5 into 2 is 10, 10 plus 1 is 11 upon 2, minus 4 times 8 is 32, and 32 into 7 is 39 upon 8. 4 times 8 is 32, 32 plus 7 is 39. Now, LCM of the denominators. So 8 is the LCM. We have done lots of practice, and I'm sure that looking after these two numbers, you can confidently say that yes, 8 is the LCM, because 8 is the first multiple of 8, right? And in 2, the first multiple that is common is 8 only. So LCM is 8. So let's now, second step, convert these fractions to like fractions. So to get the denominator 8, we will multiply by 4. So 44 upon 8 minus, this remains as it is. So our answer would be 14 minus 9 is 5 upon 8 is our answer. I hope you all have got the same answer, and even if you have got some other answer, but you have now understood how we have got 5 upon 8. That is the correct answer. Next question. 2 upon 3 plus 7 upon 12. Super easy question. Go for it, kids. Here, the LCM, 12 is the first multiple of 12 only. So it is the lowest, the smallest multiple of 12, the first multiple of 12. And in 3, we have 12 when it is 3 times 4 is 12. So 12 is going to be LCM. So to get denominator 12, we are going to multiply by 4. 4 2 is 8, 4 3 is 12, plus 7 upon 12 as it is. So 8 plus 7 is 15 upon 12. So now here we could have, since it is an improper fraction, we could have converted into mixed fraction, but check your options. In the options given, you don't have to convert it. It is only the improper fraction, and we have got the same answer, 15 upon 12. So this is our final answer. Reduce 21 upon 8. Now reduce means to reduce in simplest form or to simplify. The question could also have come, simplify 21 upon 28. Reduce 21 upon 28. These mean the same thing. All right. So how do we reduce? Now, since we have to reduce, so we are going to divide with the common number. common number that we can divide the numerator also and the denominator also. So let us find out whether we can divide 21 and 28 with a same number. 21 comes in 7's table, 3's table. So in 7's table, we have 28 also. So we can very well divide with 7. 7 3's are 21 and 7 4's are we have 28. So 3 upon 4 has been given in your options and this is the correct answer. To reduce or to simplify, it means that we have to divide with the same number, the numerator and denominator. We cannot, please understand kids, we cannot do it like this, that we divide the numerator with 3 and denominator with 7. No, absolutely not. It has to be the same number. 4 over 6. Now 4 over 6, you have to look at the options. What options are you given? Now 4 over 6. In the options, you can see that it has been in the simplified form. So 4 and 6, we can very well divide by 2. And the answer here we have got is 2 upon 3, which is your option A. Next question is 20 over 36. Now you can see the options over here. These are the reduced ones. So let us further reduce these two numbers, numerator and denominator, and both of them. Yes, we can very well reduce them by 4. So it is 4 5s are 20 and then 9, 5 upon 9. So C is your correct answer. One upon 4. So this is the mixed number or mixed fraction. So first we will convert it into improper fraction. See children, please, you have already done this. You can pause the video, solve it, and then check your answer when I'm telling you the answer. All right, since we have many questions, so I'm just giving a small pause and then explaining you the question leading to the answer. So this is 1 is to 4. So 1 upon 4, 4 ones are 4 plus 1 is 5. So the improper fraction is 5 upon 4. Now, as you can see, kids, numerator, denominator, they cannot be divided with any one number. So this is our answer, 5 upon 4. Please don't lose confidence when you find a number which cannot be simplified further. It can happen, it may happen that you get a fraction which you cannot simplify further. So you will have to write it as it is. And yes, trust yourself that yes, this question was that easy that you just got the answer at one go. Next one is to 1 upon 4. So 2 4s are 8, 8 plus 1 is 9. So this is 9 upon 4. Have confidence, you cannot simplify it further. 9 upon 4. Let's move on to our next question. Write as a mixed number, 3 upon 2. So 3 upon 2 is an improper fraction. So absolutely we can convert it into mixed fraction or mixed number. So our numerator goes inside as the denominator. Our denominator becomes the divisor. And here if we will divide, we'll get the remainder 1 and question 1. Now to write on as the mixed number, our denominator remains the same. The quotient becomes the whole number and remainder becomes the numerator. So 1 upon 2 is your correct answer. Which of the following is an improper fraction? Improper fraction in which numerator is greater than the denominator. So over here, 2 upon 3, no. 3 upon 2? Yes, the numerator is greater than the denominator. And this is a mixed fraction and this is a proper fraction or a unit fraction. So B is our correct answer. Which of the following is a mixed number? Very easy. This is 123. So this is not a mixed number. 12 upon 3, it's an improper fraction. 2 upon 3, it's a proper fraction. Now here, 1, 2 upon 3, this is your mixed number. 1, 2 upon 3. 1 where 1 is the whole number. A mixed number is a combination of whole number and a proper fraction. So write 22 upon 3 as the mixed number. So already as explained, numerator becomes your dividend, denominator becomes your divisor. And over here, 3 times 7 is 21. We get the remainder as 1. So as already told, the denominator remains the same. Quotient becomes your whole number and remainder is your numerator. So A part is your correct answer. See, now the question is simplify 6 upon 12. So either it is simplify written or reduced it is written. They mean the same thing. They mean the same thing. So 6 upon 12. What common number we can take? Absolutely 6 itself. So when the dividend and the divisor are same, or we are dividing the number by itself, we get the quotient as 1. And over here it is 12 divided by 6 is 2. So our answer, correct answer is 1 upon 2. So we are at the 17th question. We have in total 40 questions. 6 upon 9. Here at the options, we can simplify it further. So 6 upon 9 comes in. Absolutely, 3 is stable. So we are going to divide the numerator and denominator by 3. Sorry, 2 upon 3 is your answer. Next question. 8 upon 10 plus 3 upon 5. 8 upon 10 plus 3 upon 5. Now both these numbers, they are unlike fractions. They are different. They have different denominators. So what will be our first step? Yes, LCM of the denominators, and that is 10. So LCM is 10. So let's convert them into like fractions. 8 upon 10 is already with the denominator 10. Whereas 3 upon 5, let us convert with the denominator 10. So we have to multiply by 2. So 3 twos are 6 and 5 twos are 10. So our final answer over here is 14 upon 10. Now 14 upon 10, you can further simplify it. Here, 7, 2 sevens are 14. And over here, you can write 5. So 7 upon 5 is your improper fraction. Still, we have to convert it into mixed number. So 7, 5, 1, 2. So the answer is denominator 5, remainder, and the quotient. 1, 2 upon 5. So over here, this is your answer. 1, 2 upon 5. Here you can see that we have divided 14 upon 10 with the number 2. So 2 7s are 14, 7, and here it is 5 7 upon 5. On dividing 7 upon 5, 7 is the dividend, 5 is your divisor. So 1, 7 minus 5 is 2. So the remainder becomes your numerator, quotient becomes your whole number, and denominator remains the same. So the answer is 1, 2 upon 5. Next one is 24 upon 5. We have to convert it into a mixed number. Come on, go for it. All right. So numerator becomes your dividend. Denominator is your divisor. Let us divide, and you get the new remainder as 4. So our answer will be, denominator remains the same, quotient becomes your whole number, and remainder becomes your numerator. So 4 upon 5 is your final answer. Convert to an improper fraction. Come on, guys. This shouldn't take more than 5 seconds. To convert a mixed number into improper fraction, we multiply the whole number with the denominator. So this is 5 into 2 is 5 times 2 is 10 over here. And then we add the numerator. So 11 is your numerator. Do not forget to write the denominator also. So 11 upon 5 is your improper fraction. Here is the answer. All right, now some interesting questions. Here you have mixed numbers in the multiplication form. So let's start solving them. You can pause the video, solve it by yourself without listening to my explanation, and then check your answer. 5 2s are 10, 5 times 2 is 10, 11 upon 5 multiplied by 5 upon 2. Now over here, very easy, that we can see that we have 5 and 5, so we can simply cut them, we can simplify them. And then we are left with 11 upon 2. Our answers over here are given in mixed form. So let us convert it into mixed number. So our answer would be, denominator remains the same, 5, 1 upon 2 is our answer. Next question, change to a mixed number. Now this is your improper number. We have to convert into a mixed number. Before converting it, we can see that we have 0, 1, 1, 0 in numerator and denominator. So we can cut these zeros, and we have 3 upon 2. So let us convert 3 upon 2 in mixed number. So the answer is, denominator remains the same, whereas remainder becomes your numerator and quotient becomes your whole number. So the answer is, correct answer is B part. Next is change to a mixed number. Again, you have 36 upon 9. If possible, then you must simplify. You can see that 36 and 9, they come in 9's table, absolutely. So we can divide the numerator and denominator by 9. So that will be 4 upon 1, or simply 4. So the answer is 4. Now 14 upon 3. We cannot simplify it, since 3 is, 14 doesn't come in 3's table, and 3 is a prime number, right? So now here we'll have to just divide and convert it into mixed number. So 3 times 4 is 12. So over here, denominator remains the same, quotient and remainder. So 2 upon 3 is your answer. Next question. Change to a mixed number. 20 upon 8. Come on, guys. 20 upon 8, we can very well simplify it. Absolutely. With 4, we can simplify it. So 5 upon 2. 5 upon 2 is your answer given over here. Oh, wait. We have to convert it into mixed number. So we'll have to convert it first. So our answer is 2, 1 upon 2. See here, they got us in a hurry. We would have taken this 5 upon 2, thinking that 5 upon 2 is our correct answer. We got the same answer, but the question is asking mixed number. All right. Again, change to mixed number, 10 upon 4. Simplify if needed. Absolutely, we will. It comes in 2 stable, both the numbers. So 5 upon 2. Denominator remains same, and here we have got the answer. Here it is saying do not simplify. So convert into improper. So 4 into 3 is 12 plus 1 is 13, and denominator is 3. So 13 upon 3 is your correct answer. Change to an improper fraction. This is the mixed number, 8, 7 upon 8. So how do we convert into improper? Multiply 8 times 8 is 64, plus 7 is 71. So 71 upon 8 is your answer. What does the bar in a fraction mean? Suppose if you have 4 upon 2, so the question is asking about this bar. What does this bar mean in the fraction? Absolutely, it means divide. To change an improper fraction to a mixed number, what should you do? We have already done lots of questions right now. So to change an improper fraction to a mixed number, we divide the numerator by the denominator. To change a mixed number into an improper fraction, which two operations do we use? We multiply the denominator and the whole number and then add the numerator. The next is very easy, 1 upon 2. 3 upon 4. Now, as you can see, both numerator, denominator, both the fractions, we cannot simplify it. So we will straight away multiply them. Numerators multiply. 1 times 3 is 3. 2 times 4 is 8. So 3 upon 8 is your correct answer. Now, next you see. This is something interesting. Here you can have the simplification going on. 5 ones are 5 and 5 twos are 10, right? Now diagonally, if you again see, it is 4 ones are 4 and 4 threes are 12. So the answer you are getting finally is 2 upon 3. In multiplication, we not only can... Suppose not only can simplify in one fraction only, but we can simplify diagonally also. But we cannot simplify denominator, denominator, or numerator, numerator, no. We can solve it like this, simplify like this, or like this. All right. Next question. These are the mixed fractions given to you. So 4 into 2 is 8. 8 plus 1 is 9 upon 2. Multiplied by 11 upon 3. So on simplifying, we can see that 3 1s are 3 and then 3 3s are 9. No further simplification we can do. So here 3 times 11 is 33 upon 2. So this is our correct answer. Very well, everyone. Going really well. Now 35, 5 more questions left. Now finally, we have come down to division. So now, first thing first, whenever you see a mixed fraction, first you convert into improper fraction. 11 upon 2 divided by 4 upon 5. Now when the division is there, please understand, kids, we can divide the whole numbers, 4 divided by 2. But we cannot divide two fractions. Can I write like this, 4 upon 5 and here 11 upon 2? No, that is not possible, right? So to divide the fractions, when we have two fractions, we have to divide them. We write the reciprocal of the divisor. The opposite of division is multiplication. So we reciprocate the divisor over here. Now let us see if we can simplify. No, we cannot simplify. So it is 55 upon 8. Our answer is 55 upon 8. But we will see if we can convert it into, yes, we can, because it is an improper fraction. So 8 sevens are 56. So we will take 8 sixes are 48. All right. So the answer would be 6, 7 upon 8. This is your correct answer. Let us take one more of division. 3 upon 7 divided by 2 upon 5. Now division, we cannot divide the two fractions. So we are going to write the reciprocal of the divisor. All the four numbers are prime numbers. So we are just going to write the 15 upon 14 is your answer. Next question. So first thing first, whenever you see a mixed number, we first have to convert it into improper fraction. I think this question we have already done. It is the repeated one. All right. So first things first, 4 twos are 8, 9 upon 2. Now for division, what do? We write the reciprocal of the divisor. The denominator becomes the numerator, numerator becomes the denominator. So let us simplify it. 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, 3 1s are 3, 3 3s are 9. So 1 upon 6 is your answer. Second last question, everyone. Very easy, extremely easy. Over here, children, whenever you have a question like this, you can put 1 as the denominator for better clarity. So over here, our answer is 50 upon 3. Simple, nothing doing, because numerators, denominators, you can see that we cannot simplify them. Last question. What is the first step in changing a mixed number to an improper fraction? What is the first step in changing a mixed number to an improper fraction? The first step is we multiply the whole number and the denominator. I hope kids, this complete revision drill has been fruitful to you and has made many concepts even more clear than before. All the best, kids.